Hey guys, welcome to the Future of Media panel here at the Blockchain Open Forum. My name is Abigail Arterburn. I am a community manager at Gifto. And I'm really excited to be the moderator on this panel today. We have so many amazing KOLs here and thought leaders in the crypto industry. So let's get started. Can you guys go ahead and introduce yourselves and talk about how you got your start in becoming a content creator?
Hello, I'm Soso from Soso Lab. I was a medical doctor before I started crypto. And then I learned about Ethereum. And actually, I become in a rabbit hole that was very a new world, and I think it will change the world, like internet changed it. So I quit my doctor job, and now I'm a full-time cryptocurrency worker. I do videos and stuff like that. And I do it because I believe when people understand crypto more, everyone will be a part in the world, and it will change the world that we are living now.
안녕하세요. 비트 고수 스펑키예요. 다들 오늘 폭락해서 마음 아프죠, 말이 되게 속상하죠. Hi guys, my name is Spunky. I'm just a guy who bought at 20K, and I'm heartbroken because it's dipping every day. And I'm studying the blockchain technology, trying to understand if I should hold this or not, you know? Just like everyone else here, I just want to be rich, make some cool stuff, and have fun, enjoy the ride. Everybody's saying we're going to go back up. I still question everything, but I think we'll make it, so enjoy the show.
Hi, I'm Ismail Malik, founder of Blockchain Lab, and more recently and over the last year and a half been running the ICO Crowd, which you may know it's a print publication, so we've sort of gone back in traditional publishing, and I also run the ICO Crowd Network, which is a network of influencers that builds around, so we do sort of content that's not white papers and that's not websites.
My name is Killer Whale, and I'm currently associated with Chain Partners. And the reason why I started crypto was because I quit my job because I really hated my previous job. And I had some money that I wanted to invest, but I didn't know anything about stock. So the first thing I invested was Ripple. And as soon as I bought Ripple, the price went down. So instead of selling Ripple, I really studied hard to understand and make me feel better about losing the money. But I studied really hard about Ripple, and I found it really fascinating. And as you may know, the price of Ripple went up a lot. And after Ripple, I studied Ethereum, I studied Bitcoin, after that EOS and everything. And after that, I decided to YouTube because I wanted to influence other people. I wanted to educate other people upon this issue. And that's how I got started.
Hi, I'm Jade from Blog Info YouTube channel, and how I started is I used to invest in stock, and then I used this Kakao exchange app. So Kakao is like the big company in Korea, and I read this article saying Kakao is kind of preparing for the cryptocurrency exchange app, another kind of similar to the Kakao exchange stock exchange app. So I thought, all right, there is something I don't know, but I should know. So I started to work and learn and study about the blockchain and cryptocurrency. Then the exchange from Kakao, it turns out to be the Upbit right now. So I didn't know the name back then, but still that's how I got in. And I wanted to explain this new technology to people as easy as possible. So that's how I started as a creator.
Great, thank you guys so much for sharing. As you can see, everyone has a pretty diverse background and has their own story of how they came to the crypto space. Could we elaborate a little bit more on what drew you into the area of blockchain and crypto as a content creator? You know, what really kind of drew you in, and why did you get so excited about the topic?
오케이. 여기 한국 분들이 대부분에서 그냥 한국말로 할게요. 저는 블록체인에 대해서 알게 되면서부터 블록체인은 일종의 이렇게 개미지옥 같다고 생각하거든요. 그러니까 처음에는 저도 되게 가볍게 그냥 공부하면서 조금만 돈만 넣었었는데 어느 정도의 관심이 커지고 나니까 온몸이 다 빨려 들어가고 사실 지금은 이제 온몸이 다 이 크립토에 있는 그런 상황이 되고요. 사실 그거는 저한테만 일어나는 게 아니고 비단 크립토에 대해서 공부하고 그거의 개념을 이해한 분들은 대부분 이런 개미지옥에 빠져들게 된다고 생각하고요. 이게 한국은 사실 어느 정도 잠식이 올해 초에 한번 됐었다고 생각하고 전 세계적으로 이런 잠식이 일어났을 때 이 폭발력이 굉장히 클 거라고 생각해서 저는 그런 미래를 그리면서 이곳에서 제 시간과 열정을 바치고 있는 겁니다.
Should I go in English or Korean?
You can do either.
Oh, no. Well, what do you suggest?
English would be better.
So you can understand?
I realize I don't have to.
I got into crypto because just like 99% of the people in this room, I want to be rich, you know? This could be the last opportunity of our lifetimes with such amazing technology where we're at the beginning, I hope we're at the beginning, where we're getting in at the beginning for life-changing investment opportunities. And I see Bitcoin like that. I hope all of you see it like that. I still think we're still very early. I'm praying we're still very early every day. And from how it looks of it, how I see the big players coming into the market, we still got a long way to go. And just waiting for that life-changing money out of this great, out of this investment to this great technology.
Okay, so I got into crypto in that sense, if it's not blockchain, so if it's cryptocurrencies, this is a real opportunity to get in at the ground level. So startups were starting to really fade. Angel investing was getting thin on the ground. There was no real excitement. Crowdfunding was getting too regulated, too complicated. And then here came Bush, something disruptive. If you're a crowd, you can just get together, put out an idea, and if people like it, they can fund. So it was just completely disruptive of a whole system that was dying. It was just, you know, if you were in startups, you would invest, you'd get some angel stock, you sit on that stock, you never can release it, there was no instant secondary liquidity, you know, none of the excitement was there, and crowdfunding was just starting to turn into Kickstarter and Indiegogo, and you just fund a product, there was no real return, there was no real, you know, that instant gratification. So it was like the ability for you to really get in at the ground level, see who the founders are, meet them, attend events, and you know, you still get that, which you lack in any other sort of investment vehicle.
I'll be really frank, but at this point, I'm not really interested in money. I'm not here for the money. And I know this might sound really ironic, but because I'm only 25, I still think I have a bright future. I think I can earn as much money as I want in the future. But the thing that I'm very, very interested at this point is about the decentralization, and more specifically about the decentralization of data. Data was very centralized thing. Right? For instance, with Facebook, we know that it was hacked, and they sold our data. They earned billions out of that, and everything was very, very centralized. But what happens if the data becomes decentralized and one company cannot control it? Then everything would be changed, like advertisement. Everything is going to be affected by this. So I'm very interested in decentralizing of data, for instance, like Stimit or EOS or Ethereum. It's all decentralized of data. And I'm really curious how it's going to affect the whole world and the industry more specifically.
I also agree on that. And I wanted to decentralize money and power and data, so everything. But it doesn't have to be 100% decentralized, but it can be partially decentralized, I guess. And decentralizing power is like, I just want more money as a creator from the contents that I make. And I want more power as a citizen in this country that I live in. So that's how, that's why I got into this and how I think this decentralization, this new technology, blockchain, is important and probably give all of us the more power and more money from our, effort we put into in any community.
Jay, can you talk a little bit more about how you run your business on YouTube or other kind of content platforms? And then how you think blockchain will change the way you run your business and share information?
In social media?
Yeah, in business? Social media.
Okay. In my channel, in our channel, it's a company, so I'm just a worker of my company. So we mostly create, upload issues and like such as new regulations or some new issues of kind of Korean favorite cryptocurrencies. We kind of focus on that, and we also interviewed the CEO of RSK, Elf, Legolas Exchange, like CEO of the project that come to Korea to kind of spread their information of their projects. So we do that mostly. And then how this blockchain technology will change the social media, it can be like just creators on social media, like on Naver or YouTube. They might upload their contents also on Steemit and DTube, so they will earn more profit, I guess. And they will be until today, they had to kind of follow the dominant social media. No matter how they like it or not, they had to follow their reward system, their regulations. But after the blockchain, after Steemit and DTube, there could be better decentralized app, another app better than Steemit and better than DTube. But so people can probably choose the best reward system, social media, or best regulation social media they want, and they will bring more users and more profit and better ecosystem for the social media with decentralized. It doesn't have to be 100%, but kind of partially or mostly decentralized social media platform.
How about you, Soso? You run your own business, so can you talk a little bit about that and how you go about monetizing on YouTube or on other channels?
Okay, it looks like I had to use English, but I will stick in Korean anyway.
You can do Korean. I have
translated. Okay. 저희 같은 경우는 이제 최대한 이 비즈니스 모델을 유튜브로 확장시키지 않으려고 해요. 그래서 사실 오늘은 소소랩이라는 이름을 나왔지만 블록크래프터스라는 회사에서 이제 투자는 이제 싱가포르 법인으로 하고 있고 그다음에 한국 법인에서는 컨설팅이나 마케팅 쪽을 백단해서 하는 그런 쪽에서 비즈니스 모델을 오히려 잡고 있고요. 유튜브 채널 같은 경우는 오히려 공익적 목적으로 이제 에듀케이션이나 아니면 투자의 조언, 그러니까 페어한 조언이 필요하다고 생각돼가지고 ICO 프로젝트에 대해서 쓴소리를 하기도 하고 좋은 소리를 하기도 하고 그래서 그런 저희 나름대로 굉장히 중립적인 포지션을 확보하기 위해서 노력 중인데 사실 그게 되게 쉽지가 않죠. 예, 쉽지는 않은 영역이고 저희가 이걸 비즈니스 모델화 시키지 않더라고 하더라도 거기에 따른 어려움이 있을 수 있고 저희가 편향될 보일 수 있다는 점을 저희도 알고 있고 그래도 내부적으로는 치열하게 중립적인 위치를 지키려고 노력하고 있습니다.
Oh, okay, me, my channel.
Yeah.
I believe all these influencers, YouTubers, content creators, we have a lot of responsibility because a lot of people, they don't know what the hell they're doing. I mean, you guys are buying coins. You guys are buying all these shit coins, you know, scams everywhere. You're like, then you're just blaming the world for it. I mean, everything's a scam. It's all scam, you know, it's mostly scams. It's hard to find these jewels right now because this industry is just like in such a big bubble, in my opinion. So I believe influencers, people like us, we have to put our money where our mouth is at, you know? I like coins. I have a lot of projects I believe in too. I mean, I think rest are scams, but I believe in a lot of projects. And when I believe in a project, I invest heavily into it, personally. And when I invest, I invest during my live screen. I have to show my people that I'm not joking with this. You know, I buy like hundreds of thousands worth of dollars worth of certain coins because I put my money where my mouth is at. It's because I feel we have to be, people like us, we have to be super transparent with everything. You know, it's because normal, average people, retail investors, I mean, we gotta be honest here, you know, you guys don't know what you're doing. Nobody knows what they're doing. You know? I try to be as transparent as possible with my audience, and I try to be really, really honest and give my honest opinions, and I put my money where my mouth is at. So that's my channel.
Can I go next?
Yeah.
I currently don't have any monetization system, and I don't have any business model. Because if I want to make money, I would have to do a review on ICOs. But I think 99.99% of ICOs are shit. And they're pretty much all scam. Because if I know there are a lot of people who are associated with ICOs, but I genuinely don't think that it's a sustainable model.
Everything's a scam. It's all a scam.
No, that's what I genuinely believe in.
Blockchain is a scam.
I don't think ICOs are sustainable models. That's what I believe in. If it's meant to be a decentralized app, how could you possibly do a decentralized app with ICOs? Because whales gonna buy it. Pre-sales and ICO sales, they're all gonna fucking buy it. So how is it going to be a decentralized app? I think the future is going to be airdrop, personally. That's what I believe in. And if I do a review on ICO, I know that I'm gonna earn a lot of money, but I'm sorry, but that's all shit. I can't.
So, the word ICOs means an initial coin offering. Doesn't mean an initial take your money offering, right? So let's just clarify,
projects,
right?
Yeah, yeah.
So when we're doing it, token drop, right? That's an ICO, right? You've offered your coins to a group of people without having to have some sort of direct relationship, right? Much like an art. So the idea that an ICO is closely related with money, that's just the first phase, right? You're going to start to get tokens for your attention, right? So the versions we've got coming out now, if you look to basic attention token, you know, all of these are disrupting the way that you actually use your eyeballs, you use your attention. We actively reward our readers who, you know, we've got engagement with. If they spend time reading the article, if they comment, you know, they're eligible for tokens, right? So the model in how you distribute tokens, initially, we had this ERC-20 Ether. Ether was pretty cheap. You had it's a token swap, right? Where it went wrong is where a lot of people buy and physically and say, hey, you're going to give me $20,000 and this is how many tokens you're going to get. So this association with fiat and not this association. So an initial ERC-20 was an agreement that, hey, you tell me what your project's about. It's going to run on the Ethereum network. I'll swap my token for your project because I think it will have a greater utility value than my current Ethereum and hold, right? So the idea and this really narrow concept of how you've been sold ICOs, I would agree 99.9% is a scam, but the actual concept and what it does and what it delivers and how it disrupts the entire VC model is not a scam. This is the start of a token economy. This is really gonna disrupt your entire This is the beginning of the internet and the value.
The reason why I said it's not sustainable is because, first of all, during the pre-sale and ICO sale, a lot of whales come in and they buy like whole a lot of coins. So if you want to make a decentralized application, then the tokens has to be distributed in a decentralized way. But what happens if like a lot of whales come in and they actually take the whole portion of the token? Then it doesn't really work. And the second reason why I don't think it's sustainable is because as you may know, currently the market price is going down really a lot. So even if they raise around like $10 million and the market price goes down, what if they run out of money? What do they do at that point? Do they do another ICO? Like, do they do airdrop of ICO? It doesn't work like that. So I don't think it's sustainable. I know that there are like out of 100 projects, I believe that there are like 1% that is going to be successful. But for investors and for normal people, I think it's very, very risky. That's my personal opinion.
I think both of you guys came up with a very good point. I mean, the whole crowdfunding system that crypto has created from this smart contract platform, I think it's outstanding. This is just like a new way of funding and creating incredible new projects. I mean, it's outstanding. And it also gives a chance for the retail investors to participate in these outstanding projects. So the whole concept is amazing, actually. But just like how Killerwell just mentioned, it could be abused at the moment. So there still has to be a lot of rules. The system has to change to make things more equally. Because currently, we feel like we're in a stage where it's being over abused. And a lot of people, you know, people are jumping in Hangang, you know, like Han River everywhere, and it's just not looking so good nowadays, you know, because it's being overly abused. But I do believe it's great new technology. It's a great new system for crowdfunding. But just like Killerwell mentioned, there's too many problems at this moment.
Yeah. ICO 프로젝트에서 이제 리뷰를 하는 게 돈을 받는 거라든가 이런 게 큰 문제인 건 사실이에요. 대부분의 사이트, 영문 사이트를 포함해서 저희도 그런 일을 겪었고 페이먼트와 그다음에 본인들의 입장에 대한 그런 바이어스가 있는 게 사실이고 그런 면에서 사실 킬러웨일 채널이 그 ICO 프로젝트를 안 다루는 것도 하나의 정답이 될 수 있다고 생각하는데 저희 같은 경우는 안 다루는 것도 문제라고 생각하거든요. 어떤 모든 사람들은 결국 ICO 프로젝트에 투자를 하게 될 건데 개인 투자자로서 그걸 무조건 하지 마라라고 하는 게 정답일까라고 저는 생각하지는 않고요. 결국은 뉴트럴한 정보를 얻을 수 있는 채널이 있는 게 되게 중요한데 그런 채널들을 늘리는 게 오히려 저희 역할이라고 생각하고 사실 이쪽에 계속 공부를 하다 보시면 어떤 채널이 돈을 받고 스캠인 거를 광고하는 곳이고 어떤 채널이 좋은 곳을 좋은 곳이 좋은 곳이라고 하고 나쁜 곳은 나쁜 곳이라고 하는 건지 분별력이 스스로 생기는 게 사실 제일 중요하다고 생각해요. 그래서 그런 과정에 있어서 여러분들이 그 에듀케이션이라든가 그런 스스로의 스터디를 지속적으로 하는 게 여러분의 투자 스트레치지에 도움이 될 거라고 생각합니다.
네, 지금 되게 좋은 말씀해 주셨어요. 여기 옆에 소소님께서 그러니까 실제로 스스로가 강해져야 돼요, 모두가. 그러니까 저희가 지금 얘기하는 게 지금 ICO가 90% 이상, 99.9%까지 나오고 있는데 다 스캠이라고 하고 있잖아요. 다 사기고. 그러니까 유튜버들도 거의 다 스캠이야. 우리도 믿으면 안 돼요. 다 그냥 단물만 빨 줄 알아요. 단물만 빨아야 돼. 그러니까 좋은 정보만 얻은 다음에 그거를 본인이 해석하고 그 정보를 활용할 수 있는 능력들을 본인들이 스스로 다 키우는 게 지금 유일하게 성공할 수 있는 방법이라고 생각하고 있어요. 아니면은 불가능해요. 여기 완전 다 사기꾼이야, 진짜. 진짜 안 돼, 진짜 다 사기꾼이야, 진짜. 조심하세요, 정말.
Well, I was just about to say how respected you guys are as reviewers in the industry. But yeah, how do you guys choose what projects you want to review and what is your favorite project right now? What criteria goes into?
Oh, I have many things to say about that.
Okay, it's very difficult for me. 자, 그 저희는 원래는 이제 저희랑 저희가 직접 만나고 레퍼런 체크가 확실히 되는 그러니까 좀 그런 사기를 위해서 스캠을 위해서 모인 팀이 아닌 팀 위주로 원래는 리뷰를 하려고 했었는데 실제로 그래도 그 안에서 스캠이 생기더라고요. 그래서 최근에는 대부분 이제 대형 펀드들이 투자를 한 프로젝트 위주로 리뷰를 하고 있어요. 사실 엘프도 그런 거였고요. 그래서 그런 거 위주로 여러 펀드들이 들어왔으면 그 펀드들이 레퍼런 체크를 하지 않았겠냐라는 생각은 있는데 근데 결국은 그 펀드들도 사실 레퍼런 체크하는데 한계가 있는 거고 99.9%가 스캠이라는 것은 결국 한 3년 뒤, 5년 뒤에는 저희가 투자했던 대부분 프로젝트들이 망할 확률이 솔직히 높아요. 그리고 그 과정에 있어서 근데 중간 차익을 거두는 게 나쁜 투자라고 생각하지는 않거든요. 그래서 그 중간 차익이 될 만한 것들에서 탄탄한 기초 체력이 있고 그다음에 그런 중간 차익 망하는 것에서 살아남는 나중에 구글이나 아마존이 될 수 있는 그런 회사를 찾는 것을 목표로 하고 있지만 솔직히
그게 성공할 수 있을지는 저도 장담하지 못하겠어요. 그거는 제 채널뿐만 아니라 다른 분 채널들도 보시고 영문 채널도 보시고 최대한 많은 공부를 하시면서 스스로 투자를 해야 되는 게 정답이라고 생각합니다.
네, 다 한국말 좋아하셔서 한국말로 할게요. 그냥 투자를 제가 이거 여기서만 드리는 꿀팁, 진짜 꿀팁. 제가 요즘에 정말 오랜만에도 한 50개 프로젝트에 제가 투자를 했어요, 개인적으로. 다 개판이에요, 근데 보면은. 그러니까 지금 그러면서 이제 시행착오를 거치면서 수업료를 내고 제가 배운 게 있다면은 방금 전에 소소님이 말씀하신 거랑 비슷한 점도 있는데 그 여러분들이 그 특정 프로젝트를 운영하고 있는 CEO부터 해가지고 운영하는 그 이사진들 막 그 스펙과 막 그런 거 보고 막 우왕 하면서 막 포머 해가지고 그냥 막 돈 다 받고 그러잖아요. 그거 보시면 안 되고요. 그 프로젝트에 투자하는 사람들을 보세요. 왜냐면요, 그 프로젝트에 투자하는 사람들은요, 여러분과 저와 같아요. 돈 벌러 들어가는 거예요. 네? 그 돈 잃으러도, 돈을 잃기 위해서 투자하는 사람은 세상에 없어요. 돈을 벌기 위해서 투자한단 말이에요. 그러니까 뭔가 뒤에서 뭔가 그 이게 최악의 상황에서도 뭔가 무슨 구멍이 있는 거야, 애들이. 그러니까 약간 그런 관점을 조금 생각해야 되고, 그리고 이분들은 투자를 했을 때는 돈을 많이 벌기 위해서 들어가지 무슨 10% 단타 치러 들어간 게 아니에요. 그 정말로 투자에 이 능숙한 이런 단체들은. 그렇기 때문에 아무리 CEO가 무슨 구글 출신이고 뭐고 다 스캠이에요, 어차피. 그 프로젝트에 전략적으로 투자하는 단체들을 많이 보고 그 단체들이 왜 여기에 투자를 하고 있는지 거기를 전화해서 물어보든 어떻게 정보를 캐가지고 그걸 이제 획득하고 그런 정보를 찾는 데 많이 주력하시는 걸 제가 정말 추천해드리고 싶어요. 저희는 시행착오를 거치면서 맨날 무슨 구글부터 해가지고 무슨 뭐 우버 어쩌고저쩌고 사장들이 있어가지고 다 투자해봤는데 아 다 쓰잘데기 없더라고. 그러니까 정말 진짜 강한 투자 단체들이 들어가면서 돈 벌러 들어간 놈들이 진짜 돈을 벌기 위해서 들어간 거거든요. 걔네를 좀 많이 식별해내고 그런 그룹들이 어디인지 그리고 걔네가 왜 들어가는지 어떤 진짜 뒤에서 무슨 최악의 상황까지 대처하는 어떤 계획을 갖고 들어가는지 이런 부분들을 좀 잘 식별하는 능력들을 키우시는 걸 저는 적극적으로 진짜 경험에서 많은 수업료 내면서 나온 이 경험담을 좀 드리고 싶습니다. 세력이고 작전이요? 그런 것도 많죠. 근데 이 바닥은 법이 없어요. 네, 그걸 탓할 수도 없어요. 지금까지는, 아직까지는 올해 이제 막 금방 바뀌겠지만. 네. 그러니까 그 정보를 획득해야죠. 그러니까 그렇게 들어가는지 안 들어가는지 아니면 그런 배를 같이 타시거나 정말로 되게 이게 슬픈 현실인데 거의 폰지 게임이 돼가고 있어가지고 지금은 되게 많이 위험해요. 많이 위험하기 때문에 좀 많이 조심하셔야 된다고 생각해요. 하지만 미래는 밝아요. 그러니까 지금 저희가 약간 그 뭐라 하지 전방에서 그 총알받이 해주는 약간 역할을 해주고 있는 것 같은데 이 초기 분들이 그 앞으로 아름다운 미래를 위해서 지금 다 시체밭이 되고 있거든요. 그러니까 그 아름다운 미래 결국에는 잘 될 건데 그 기간이 가는 데까지가 굉장히 고통스러울 수 있기 때문에 가는 그러면 분산 투자 잘 하시면서 저점 잘 잡고 어쨌든 간에 최대한 많은 네트워크 그냥 친구 말 듣고 막 솔깃해가지고 막 이런 짓 하지 마시고 아주 상식적인 것만 지키셔도 평탄을 치실 수 있다고 생각하고 있어요.
그 sorry. No, it's fine. So I'm just saying this term good project, right? So you can have a good project that's going to make social impact, right? It's going to help feed some people. You can have a good project that you can flip within 6 weeks as soon as it hits an exchange and there's going to be buyers, or you can have a good project that's going to give you a slow and steady return over several years. If you Google now Ethereum, read the CoinDesk articles in the early days of Ethereum, it was painted far from a good project, right? And then it done, I don't know, 30,000x from there, right? So a bad project today might be a really good project, right? So if you look at XRP and Ripple, it was like 0.001. It was a bad project for a while, right? XRP was going nowhere. And then Bush, right? So time is relative to what a good project, right? So if you're a flipper, You have a very different metric. You look at how much FOMO is on that project. Is there a lot of people who really wanted to be in that project and missed out? That's going to get a bump on the exchange. If you want a steady return, maybe you want to start looking at security ICOs, right? So, you know, there is a different model of an ICO depending on what's good for you. Personally, I want to see something highly disruptive. I want to see it challenge an existing industry. I want to see some really brave, really, you know, go get hungry leaders, right? I don't want to see safe players. And, you know, if it fails, it fails. But if it really kicks in, that's 1,000x, right? That, you know, so, you know, you want to don't put your dial up too hard and say, hey, I didn't really like the way that founder dressed, or he seems to spend all his nights late night or whatever. You know, have a look at how hungry, how it, you know, how disruptive, what they're pushing, because that's going to be your 1,000x, right? And if you've got a portfolio, you know, you only need a few really, really good projects that are going to push your whole portfolio up. You don't need to have every single one. It's no good having 10 safe, really sensible, all really good universities, white papers, all edited and all the spellings correct, and those 10 projects go nowhere. That is not how you do it. So take some risk. The ones that are risky, the ones that are disruptive, are the ones that are going to give you reward. When Vitalik first put out, sat around in small groups and said, I'm doing this smart contract platform, everybody who was just on largely on Bitcoin and a few other networks was like, this is ridiculous. You are never going to achieve that. This is a scam, you know, blah, blah, blah. But, you know, we could see differently today.
저도 한국말로 할까요? Is that okay?
Yeah, of course.
그래서 저 같은 경우는 일단 첫 번째로 백서에 정말 많은 시간을 투자하는 것 같아요. 그러니까 백서를 한 1년 동안 한 2, 300개 정도는 읽은 것 같은데 읽다 보면은 비슷한 점도 많아, 그러니까 베낀 백서들이 워낙에 많아서 조금 수준이 낮은 백서를 읽게 되면은 옛날에 읽었던 부분이 똑같이 써있네 이런 부분들이 되게 많아요. 베낀 것도 되게 많고 허접하게 쓴 백서도 되게 많은데 일단 백서의 모든 거를 다 그 백서 기반으로 이게 성공할 거다 아닐 거다를 판단할 수 없는 건 아는데 일단 백서부터가 전 첫 번째 단계라고 생각이 들어요. 그거부터 허접하게 쓰여 있다면 그 프로젝트에 대한 오해가 많이 생길 거고 그로 인해서 투자했을 때 위험성이 높아질 거라고 좀 판단을 하고 있기 때문에 일단 백서에 정말 많은 시간을 투자를 하고요. 그리고 두 번째로 지금 보고 있는 거는 이게 실제로 코인이 사용성이 있는가에 대해서 정말 유틸리티가 있는가에 대해서 정말 많이 보는데 예시를 들어주면 바이낸스 코인 같은 경우 일단 실제로 사용이 되고 있거든요. 그러니까 사용이 되는 게 되게 중요하고 많은 유저들이 그 코인을 사용해야지만 그 가치가 있다고 생각이 들기 때문에 그 두 번째 기준으로 보고 그리고 세 번째로는 토큰 이코노미를 보는데 그러니까 시간이 지나면 지날수록 이 코인의 희소성이 높아지는가에 대해서 되게 공부를 많이 하는 것 같아요. 그러니까 바이낸스 코인이 투자라는 건 절대 아니고요. 그러니까 바이낸스 코인에 대해서 얘기를 드리자면 매 분기마다 그 코인의 그러니까 수익을 벌어들인 것에 대해서 20%를 다시 바이낸스 코인을 사요. 그걸 소각을 시키는 거예요. 그러니까 절대적 양이 가면 갈수록 줄어들 수밖에 없는 코인이고 리플 같은 경우도 송금을 할 때 그 코인이 줄어들 수밖에 없는 희소성이 높아질 수밖에 없거든요. 그래서 그렇게 세계적으로 전 총체적으로 보고 판단을 하는 것 같습니다.
네, 킬러웨이님 오늘 월급 받으면 바이낸스 코인 풀매수 하신다고 했는데 했어요?
아니 아직 월급이 안 나와서.
알았어요.
저는 그 저 영상 만들 때도 항상 얘기를 하는 게 인생은 혼자 사는 거고 진짜 아무도 믿지 말라고 얘기를 하거든요. 그래서 진짜 뭐 유명한 사람들 워렌 버핏, 뭐 빌 게이츠, 뭐 레드 갈링하우스 뭐 이런 사람들 아무도 믿지 말라고 말씀을 드리고 그리고 이 세상에 완벽한 프로젝트는 정말 단 하나도 없을 거예요. 그래서 절대 장점만 사실 저희는 많이 접하게 되거든요. 정보를 아무리 그냥 기본적으로 프로젝트 하나를 유튜브든 어디에서든 구글에서든 검색을 하면은 사실 그냥 정보만 나오고 이제 좀 좋은 것만 나와요. 왜냐면은 그 정보들이 대부분 프로젝트를 만든 사람으로부터 나오는 정보를 저희가 이제 복사해서 붙여넣기 하는 수준으로 그렇게 정보 모으고 하는 식으로 나오기 때문에 대부분 단점이 적혀 있는 백서 아마 보기 힘드실 거고 웹사이트 보기 힘드실 거고 팀 멤버들도 아, 이런 좋은 데 있었다 하지만은 아, 이런 실패한 데도 있었다라는 사람들 많이 못 보실 거예요. 그래서 그런 거를 꼭 보셔야 됐으면 좋겠 아 보시면 좋겠고 그리고 항상 저 영상 만들 때도 프로젝트를 이제 리뷰를 할 때도 꼭 이제 장점이랑 단점 두 개 다 보여드리려고 노력을 하는 편이긴 한데 일단 최대한 정보를 검색을 계속 해보시면 저도 처음에는 아, 이 웹사이트, 이 프로젝트 영상만 봐도 아, 이거 진짜 좋은 것 같다. 팀멤버도 좋아 보여. 투자자도 심지어 좋아 보여. 투자기관 좋네 라고 하더라도 나중에 글을 읽어보면은 실제로는 정말 아, 블록체인이 전혀 필요가 없는 프로젝트인 경우도 있거든요. 그래서 투자기관도 사실 유명한 투자기관들 많지만 돈을 벌러 들어오는 거긴 한데 그 사람들이 같이 이 프로젝트에 투자하는 투자자들까지 생각해주지 않거든요. 그래서 이제 뭐 프로젝트 아이쇼에 투자를 해서 이렇게 하다가도 상장을 하고 상장을 해서 상승을 하고 나면 또 바로 이제 그냥 매도를 해버리고 뒤도 안 돌아보는 그런 기관들도 있기 때문에 절대 뭐 기관도 믿지 마시고 그냥 아무도 안 믿으시고 저희 유튜버도 절대 믿으시면 안 되시고 그냥 자기 자신이 스스로 어쩔 수 없이 자기 돈은 자기 말고는 지켜줄 사람이 없어요. 그래서 꼭 본인이 먼저 많이 공부하시고 판단을 꼭 본인이 하시면 좋겠습니다.
Can I just ask a question?
Yeah, go ahead.
So I just, how many of the audience are still holding their tokens and going to ride out this dip? Just translate.
네, 지금 아직 그 손절 안 하시고 다 똥코인들 계속 잡고 계신 분들 손 들어주세요. 저 겁나 많은데. 진짜.
Right. So you are all believers, right? You're all believers in this token economy, right? You see a future in it, right? So even if the token's not doing well or there's a change in direction, you have now subscribed and joined the new economy. You are now a part of the economy because you're still holding and not panicking, right? So this belief, this joint thinking, this global community, this is the token economy, this is the strength, this is crypto, right? So if you have people who are holding when it's tough, that means that this community has got attention, members, and people giving it energy. This itself is the token economy, right? So even if some of these tokens have zero utility, but you're still transacting, and there's velocity, and there's belief in them, they will still have a value above zero just for doing that.
Thank you so much for sharing all of these ideas. I think that one thing that really resonates with me is this idea of disruption and coming from a background of studying internet policy, I think you can really start to identify those projects that are really going to be impactful in the future and changing the model of the internet. I know for us at Gifto, we look at the current model and it's all just an ad-based model of the internet, but I like to believe that with decentralized technology, you're able to kind of transfer that power back into the consumer's hands. So I think it's been really, really interesting and informative to hear from all of you guys today about how you review projects and what you see as far as, ICOs go. So thank you guys so much for joining us today in the future of media in cryptocurrencies.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.